If you want to grow on Twitch, you need to go above and beyond. Your stream can't just be gameplay and chatting anymore. That's why I'm going to give you 7 ways that you can instantly make your stream more engaging so that when viewers drop by, they don't just leave instantly. Let's go. Hey, I'm Eljay from streamscheme.com. I'm also a variety streamer over at twitch.tv/LJM_. There are links to streamscheme.com and to me in the description. So if you want to check me out while I'm live, go for it. Today, I'm going to be showing you guys how to make your stream much more engaging. Whether it's simply learning how to cut in while you're live, or maybe it's potentially to add a custom overlay. Maybe it's learning how to use voice mods, or simply adding sound effects to your stream. Today, I'm going to get you guys looking great. Speaking of looking great, let me know in the comments if you have a really engaging stream or you know someone who has a really engaging stream. I'd love to jump around and check some of you guys out or some of your suggestions out. Speaking of checking things out and looking great, let me tell you about our sponsor, Own.TV. I'm sure you guys know about Own.TV now already, but I gotta throw it out there. They are your one-stop shop for all things streaming related. Whether it's getting a full animated overlay pack for your stream or simply grabbing some sub badges or maybe some emotes, they've got everything you can need to get yourself up and running on the go. I've said it before, but Owned have turned installation into an art. A lot of their packs, you can simply just double click and it will start installing. Massive thank you to Owned for supporting this channel. Without them, I couldn't do it. So guys, if you're looking to buy something, click the link in the description because it really helps us out and lets this channel grow. Speaking of the description, there's also time codes down there. So feel free to check those out and skip ahead to whatever part of this video you want. Let's start with one of the easiest ways and also probably one of the most effective ways I've found when it comes to adding a bit more emphasis to your words and also being a lot more engaging. I come from a filmmaking background, and one of the techniques to make speech much more engaging is to use a wide, medium, or close-up and cut between them depending on what is being said. For example, if I said, "Subscribe or else your family gets it," it doesn't really do anything. But if I said, "Subscribe or else your family gets it," then it adds a lot more emphasis to the statement. To do this while live, all you need to do is grab your camera layer, duplicate it, layer it on top of the old camera, grab the top one, zoom the camera in a bit, and then you can keybind it either in your settings to toggle the source on and off, as seen on screen now. You can go to settings, hotkeys, find your scene you're working in, find the layer, and then hotkey it to a button you don't use, such as your numpad, for example. Or if you have an Elgato Stream Deck or a Stream Deck alternative, usually they're very simple and easy ways to set that up. Repeat this process again, but zoom in a bit further, and then you've got your wide, your medium, and your close-up all good to go. And then while you're live, you can manually cut in easily. If you want to set this up inside your game screens where you're not using a full screen camera, it's very easy to do again. All you have to do is follow the same steps as I showed you a second ago. However, when you've zoomed in, obviously it'll go outside your webcam box, so you just hold Alt and drag it back in to crop it. I love voice changes because I feel like they're a great way to add a little bit more emphasis and break up the monotony that comes with sometimes a big long stream. For example, if I want to get everyone's attention, I can stand here and I can go, "Chat, tab back in, I need your help with something." Or if I wanted to, I could make myself sound like a god.
And then hard transition into sounding like a chipmunk.
Or I can go ahead and add auto-tune to it.
Or pretend like I'm on the phone, hello 911.
They've all got really good uses that can help you engage or make someone laugh. For example, if I said to you guys, "Hey, subscribe or else your family gets it," then it doesn't really do much. But if I said to you,
"Subscribe or else your family gets it,"
then it adds a lot more emphasis. Now, I use a GoXLR for all of my effects, and it's actually the reason why I bought the GoXLR Large rather than GoXLR Mini. The Mini doesn't come with any of these reverb effects or any of the samples. And truthfully, it's really intuitive to use. Honestly, I have zero issues using this GoXLR. I set it up on day one, and it's just been gold every single day of the week. Well, you don't need a GoXLR when you're starting out, especially not to do voice mods. For example, you can use a free option or a freemium option like Voice Mod. When I say freemium, I mean that it's half locked behind a paywall and half free. The way Voice Mod works is it's software that takes your microphone signal, edits it, and then you send that signal back into Slobs and OBS as a new virtual microphone. This way you toggle the software on and off, and it simply adds the mod that you have set up. I don't want to go in too deep about how to set it up because there's plenty of videos. If you do want an entirely free option and you're an OBS user, then I've actually linked in the description a tutorial by Nutty. I know I talk about him all the time, and he shows you how to use VST plugins to pretty much set up full voice changes and voice mods as much as you want. My actionable tip here is to really try and find out how you can incorporate a voice changer into your stream. Not all the things I've shown you today will be perfect for you, but I'm sure there is some way you can take the voice mods and make them work with your content. Let's talk music. Now, I come from a filmmaker's background, and that means that I absolutely hate music. Or at least the way that most streamers actually use music, because it's being used completely wrong. The way most people pitch music is they pitch it as background tracks, but the reality is music adds so much to a stream and so much to videos as well. It can completely change the energy your chat has. It can completely change the vibe that your entire stream has. And honestly, it can get people so engaged so quickly. I've mentioned how my entire first 5 minutes of my stream is actually choreographed to music. I have a song that plays for a perfect amount of time, and then I transition into another song that has a perfect drop after 10 seconds. Everything lines up, and then I start my stream and go through all of the process. People are used to it, and they know to expect it, and it gets them super hyped up. I've also got other tracks, so if I'm going to do something epic, like take on a Dark Souls boss, or maybe it's the final bracket of a tournament about which dessert is the best dessert, then I'll turn on my epic boss music, and we'll fight it out to that. Or if I'm doing GeoGuessr or some other heavy quiz-based thing, then I'll chuck on some countdown music or some thinking music to really add to the emphasis of that. All of these tracks help to engage my viewers and help set a tone. And by switching on the fly, because I have them all on a playlist and open as I stream, it means that it really isn't that much hassle for me to add and set a scene perfectly. So please add music to your stream because it can really add emphasis. But also, just the lack of music can add emphasis. If I'm going to say something, or I'm going to pretend to be angry at chat, or someone calls me out, or someone says I look like fat Chris Pratt, which happens twice a stream pretty much, then sometimes you just cut all the music, and you look them dead in the eye, and you say, "Hey, what'd you say to me?" In the same vein as music adds emphasis and sets a mood, you can add sound effects to really punctuate what's going on in your stream as well. For example, a lot of my viewers will donate really bad puns as TTS, and I always finish it off with one of these. Or maybe I'm going to play some thunder if I'm in a stark and stormy horror game. Or maybe if I'm going to announce something really shocking. That one's one of my favorites, but I don't get to use it very often. I'm doing all these sound effects using sampled buttons on my Go XLR. However, you can do them with a Stream Deck, a Stream Deck alternative, or you can also set them up with Voice Mod, which I mentioned earlier, or you can just simply import them into your software and then set sources to turn on and off the same way I showed you with hotkeys earlier. Next up, let's talk about how you can make your viewers feel more engaged in chat. Now, I've talked about BetterTTV a lot, or FrankerFaceZ, which I haven't mentioned as much, but is also fantastic. But the thing is, I really need to bring this up again because you guys are missing out on having hundreds of emotes set up in your channel that is ingrained in Twitch culture. Literally, every large channel has these set up, and when someone from a large channel decides, maybe I'll watch a small streamer today, and they rock up and they can't type Omega Lull or Kek W, then it does really take away from the viewing experience and the chatting experience. So much so that I've actually been in small streamers' chats and I've seen people complain about the fact they can't use BetterTTV or they can't use FrankerFaceZ because the streamer just doesn't have it set up. You're probably a bit confused about what I'm talking about if you haven't seen this done before, but essentially, have you ever been in a chat and you've seen someone typing Omega Lull or Kek W or Cat Jam and it's just the word typed out? Well, that is actually an emote code and those people are using BetterTTV or FrankerFaceZ, and that is an extension that turns that emote code into an emote that everyone using that extension can see. And most people on Twitch have that set up so they can see an emote. You just can't. And the best thing is you don't need to be an affiliate to use this or anything like that. You can set up literally over like 100 different emotes for your channel based off other channels or even just upload your own and people can start using them straight away. It also has a huge library listed from most popular to least popular, meaning that you can just go and take the top 50 most used emotes and add them to your channel. It even uses animated emotes. So if you want to, you can either take animated emotes from that list or I'm gonna have a tutorial coming soon about how to make your own animated emotes and upload them. So let me know if you wanna see that. I've linked in the description a tutorial for how to set up BetterTTV. I really recommend everyone who wants to be a streamer or even if you're just a viewer, go get BetterTTV, look at my tutorial, get yourself set up. It is amazing and it really helps out every affiliate I've seen. The final step is turning on custom overlays such as this. And yes, you guessed it, you can either use a Stream Deck or Stream Deck alternative to turn it on, or the same way as I showed you earlier, you can set up manual hotkeys on your keyboard in order to turn them on and off. These are a really good way to add a little bit of comedic effect. For example, if I'm doing something really smart or really dumb, I can turn on this one and chat will often find it pretty funny. Or maybe I die in a game over and over again, like this one, for example, that I used a lot during Dark Souls. The hardest part about setting these up is actually creating the asset outside of Streamlabs or OBS and then adding it in. Now, if you decide to go with a still image, most likely a PNG, then it is so easy to add these in. You just have to import it, which I'll show you how to do in a second. If you choose to go a bit fancier and add something animated like this, then it's actually going to take a lot more effort, and I'm going to try and show you how to do it. But unless you have some experience with editing, you probably won't be able to do this. For example, let's search HD green screen rain. If we take something like this rain effect and we download it and take it directly into OBS or Streamlabs, then we can add the chroma key effect to it quite easily. With some fiddling, we can get an okay look. but the file is actually an MP4, meaning it can cause a lot of lag inside OBS or Streamlabs. Personally, the way I do it is I prefer to take the green screen into After Effects and then use After Effects to remove the green from it and create a WebM or transparent video file. The reason I say to use a WebM in this situation is because it's the smallest video file that still has transparency. A MOV has transparency as well. However, it is far too large. Do not use MOVs inside OBS and slobs unless you have a crazy beefy computer. This WebM is how we made all 35 free stingers that are included in our Discord as well, by the way. Now, you don't have to have After Effects here. You can technically use something like DaVinci and go in and remove the green screen in there. The problem with DaVinci though is I'm not sure it can export out WebMs, which means you have to export it out as a MOV or as a GIF file, and then use some sort of free program like Convertio to convert it from a MOV or a GIF into the WebM. All of this seems complicated, but there are ways you can do it really simply. For example, you can just search up the Grand Theft Auto wasted image and take that as a PNG and use that instead. It does the exact same thing as adding rain, it's just different. So once you have your transparent image that you're going to want to add to your scene, all you have to do is open up Streamlabs or OBS. You want to make a new scene inside your program and then import your asset. Add your camera in as well and put it below the asset, and then right click the scene, not the source, add filter, color correction, bring down the saturation. The reason I say to add filters to the scene and not your camera is because a lot of you guys have the same camera source. So if you add a filter to one camera source, it'll affect every camera source. You'll now want to go back to your game scene or wherever you want to use it, add source, add scene, and then select the scene you just built. Make sure it's at the top, and then you can set your hotkeys as shown earlier in the video, or a Stream Deck alternative to activate the source when needed, and you're all set up and good to go. The final tip of today's video is head down to the comments and type the word WHAM. Why? Because that's our 100% crew badge. Let me know that you've watched the entire video. And hey, guys, if this video helped you out and you know someone else who's trying to be a streamer and wants to make their stream really engaging, please consider sharing the content on Twitter or Facebook or wherever it is it needs to be, because it really helps us out, guys. I'll see you next week.